my first words would be to express our gratitude to the Netherlands Russian Council for Trade Promotion for organizing this seminar and for its significant mission of encouraging Russian-Dutch trade and business ties. Your presence here says a lot about the interest of the Dutch entrepreneurs in the Russian market and vice versa. Maybe to start little speech, I will have to say a couple of words about the general state of affairs, general state of our cooperation between Russia and the Netherlands. It's hugely impacted by the general standoff between the West and Russia over the Ukrainian crisis. Needless to speak about the origin of this crisis, it's a matter for maybe some other meetings. Let's say that our Western partners within the European Union told us that there would no be a business as usual. We said, okay, we don't want this business as usual either, but our reading on this situation is quite different. We don't want this business as usual as before, when Russia felt treated like minor partner. And the example was this situation over the negotiation between the EU and Ukraine, negotiation in order to achieve this agreement on trade agreement, free trade agreement between the EU and Ukraine. We told our partners in the European Commission, look, we already had the free trade agreement between Russia and the and Ukraine. And since there is about signing the agreement only free trade agreement between free trade between the EU and Russia, we are legitimately concerned over the consequences of this agreement. We were afraid, to speak frankly, about the goods of the EU coming freely without any duties to the Russian market, without any taxes, because of this or the existence of this free trade agreement between Russia and the and Ukraine within the framework of the community of the independent states. But we were not heard. The response was made, it's none of your business. We are negotiating with Ukraine. You will not have to worry. We know what we are doing. And so Russia felt absolutely ignored. This one of the examples of how Russia has been treated in the past. And therefore, we don't want this business like usual, usual in the past. Now about the sanctions. The sanctions were imposed on Russia by the European Union. Again, the appeal, the calls are made by the United States. Let's put it straightforward. We consider this to be unlawful decision. We don't agree with these sanctions, but we are not begging for the sanctions to be lifted. It's up to our Western partners, the European Union, to take the proper decision. We will be ready to tolerate this situation, to deal with as long as our partners will be thinking about the possibility of lifting the sanctions. Because of this general standoff, our political relations are somehow frozen between Russia and the Netherlands. We had some intergovernmental mechanism like Intergovernmental Commission on Trade. And unfortunately, over 3 years, this commission didn't convene. We had also the program of exchanges between our countries in all the areas, and this program seems to be abandoned completely. But however, we have some, I will say, some minimal service regarding our political relations. Speaking about our trade and economic cooperation, we needed to do everything that is possible to preserve what we have, what we had achieved in the past, and prepare the ground to lay down the basis with the hope of seeing our cooperation start forward once more, and it will be full-fledged cooperation. But now, just now, unfortunately, the whole picture is looking grim. Only 3 years ago, the trade between Russia and the Netherlands was very important. The total amount of our trade was about nearly $80 billion. Your country was our second major commercial partner in the world, just after China. But over these 2 last years, there was a steadily drop in the trade, to the effect that now, according to the Russian statistics, our trade, bilateral trade, is about 43.9 billion dollars, compared to 73 billion dollars just in 2015. You will easily see that it's dropped by nearly half, and it's very, very regretful. But however, man, even with this drop, the Netherlands still remain one of our key trade partners, number three, actually, after China and Germany. Maybe a word about the state of Russian economy. We have suffered from very unfavorable market conditions. You know, Russia was hugely dependent on oil and gas shipments, hydrocarbons, generally speaking. And with this unfavorable world market conditions, we sustained huge losses. Actually, our trade with the Netherlands, physically speaking, materially speaking, is practically the same, with even light increase. But in terms of value, in terms of prices, this is reduced by nearly 50%. However, we call that Russian economy have already touched the bottom, the lowest point in the current evaluation. We are still faced with the contraction of the GDP, gross domestic product. And even this year, there is a still drop in the GDP, in the gross domestic product. But it's twice less than over the previous period. Therefore, we consider that there is a positive trend. And overall, Russian economy proved to be resilient to these unfavorable market conditions and the impacts, very negative impacts of the sanctions. The diagnosis, this diagnosis that Russian economy has already passed the lowest point was delivered by Alexei Kudin, former finance minister, who is considered like one of the most eminent experts in Russia, who was invited by President Putin to be part of a new consultative entity, which is called the High Economic Committee, whose first meeting took place just yesterday, and many economists were present, among them Kudin, but also Glazer. These are two different point of views, two different approaches to deal with the current problems of the Russian economy. Kudin is known for his strict monetary policy, and Glazer is pushing ahead with the idea of getting even more money injected in the Russian economy, saying that this would be very helpful. Despite the inflation risk, maybe it will be a very, very good impetus for the Russian economy. But, however, there are some things that are improving, and we can speak about some positive elements that are of encouraging nature. Indeed, our reserves in foreign currencies and in gold have even increased over the past year. Now we have $390 billion, and only 3 months ago it was $140 billion. There is an increase despite this difficult conjunction. Another index that is very reliable, and you can easily understand what I am speaking about, a very low public debt. The ratio, the public debt taken compared to the gross domestic product, is only 10, maximum 14%. Shall I remember that some of the countries of the European Union with good banking ratings have the ratio absolutely different? If I'm not mistaken, your neighbors, France, have this ratio of about 92%. Italy, even higher position. But, however, some rating companies, I mean Standard & Poor's, Fitch, over the past 2 years, they steadily have degraded the sovereign rating of Russia. One of them squarely put Russia among the trash rating, with the lowest possible rating, despite this ratio of public debt and the GDP. It was obviously politically motivated, and the proof of it is the whole success of the operation launched by Russia yesterday, Eurobonds, the bonds have launched on the international monetary market with 4.5 interest percent interest annually interest, and it was a success because all the bonds were taken and there was practically the proof that Russian ratings is much more higher than the trash rating given by certain Western rating agencies. Maybe a few words about the Russian government's efforts to improve the environment for foreign investors, for foreign foreign entrepreneurs. We are doing quite a lot in this respect. Our government is keen on creating comfort conditions and environment for foreign investors. We have actually currently 28 special economic zones. Special programs providing subsidies, grants are implemented. Let me cite the example of the meeting held yesterday, that took place yesterday, between Russian president and French entrepreneurs sitting in Russia, in Moscow. Yesterday, there was a meeting, my good friend, which is the head, who is the head of the French Russian chamber in Moscow, was presiding the meeting on the French side. It was very very fruitful discussion, and President Putin praised the French businessmen, saying that there are about 500 French enterprises located in Moscow altogether, and over this difficult period, over 3 whole years of tensions, strain, none out of 500 enterprises has left the Russian market. They are still there, working, operating, and this is true also of the Italian entrepreneurs working in Moscow. Spain business people, some of them still maintain their staff in Russian enterprises, even maybe losing some money because of this difficult environment for the moment, but expecting, however, to resume the full-fledged cooperation. We do hope that our Dutch partners will do the same. There are many success stories of the Dutch businesses producing high quality products in our country. Their names are well known: Unilever, Heineken, DSM, Friesland Company, and many, many others. We continue to seek further improvements in this sphere on different levels. I would like to give you a couple of fresh examples of our activities in the Netherlands. In May, we organized two events for the Dutch businesses. The first one was a workshop devoted to the topic of avoiding risks on a stage of selection of the Russian partners or customers. Media group Interfax presented here in the Amsterdam their product, a comprehensive information system named called the Spark, allowing to check a reliability, including credit history, payment discipline, of any legal entity registered in Russia. The second event took place just 2 days ago. It was a seminar in Rotterdam with participation of a big delegation from the Russian Customs Service including its head, Mr. Andrei Belyanina. They came to the Netherlands with a clear message for the Dutch colleagues, saying that the Russian Customs Service is open for cooperation. They brought a whole number of concrete proposals regarding decreasing the administrative burden on the Dutch exporters working in Russia. All these initiatives, such as a green corridor, mutual recognition of customs control results, and some others, were presented to the participants of the seminar and were conveyed to the Dutch customs authorities. Now the ball is on their side, but we still are ready to ensure the follow-up, and Russian embassy will be eager to present to give more information on this subject. Over the past months, we see a good trend, saying that proven that there is a resumption of the cooperation, of a broad cooperation with countries such as France, Italy, Spain. With France, we will hold an intergovernmental commission headed by our country's two prime ministers, Manuel Valls on the French side, Dmitry Medvedev on the Russian side. And besides, like President Putin said yesterday, there is a growing number of French investments going to the Russian economy. And we are very glad to see this trend. We hope also that we will see positive trends here, speaking of the Russian-Dutch trade. Let me say that the overwhelming feeling among the Russians towards the Dutch people is a very positive one. Russians admire the Dutch people for their discipline, their concentration in the work. We have this long history of the relations, which goes back to the voyages, to the trip of Peter the Great, the Russian Tsar, who came to the Netherlands first, who learned much here, who brought many of his people here in order to get them to learn the Dutch experience. We have many, many common points in the history, and this autumn we will celebrate with the Dutch authorities the anniversary, 200 years since the betrothal of Anna Pavlovna, the sister of Alexander I, the Tsar, and your prince, who would be your king in the Netherlands. Therefore, let me, in conclusion, express the hope that this seminar would be very useful, will allow us to exchange views, to see how we can promote our relationships further more on the basis of friendship and with due respect for the interest of each other side. Thank you.